Good morning, students.
Welcome back. This video is for the students of class 7th subject English. In this video, we shall read our lesson number 5, Quality, from our book Honeycomb, and this is my lecture number 3 for lesson 5. So, let's start our lesson number 5, Quality. First of all, have a look on introduction of the chapter. This story is about a struggling shoemaker's dedication to his work. The author knows him as someone who thinks and works with the passion of an artist, to the limit that the shoes he makes are masterpieces in themselves. But in the end, the story tells us about the sad loss of art and quality in today's world of mass-produced big brands and consumerism. So, basically this story talks about a struggling shoemaker's dedication to his work, his hard work. There are two main characters in the story, the storyteller and the Gessler brothers. So let's start the summary of the chapter, Gessler Brothers and the Art of Boot Making. The author had known the shoemaker for many years because he used to make boots for his father. Mr. Gessler was the shoemaker who lived with his elder brother in their shop in London. The shop did not have any signs apart from the name of the Gessler Brothers. So, the storyteller, or we can say the author, know the shoemaker from many years because the shoemaker used to make boots for his father. What was the name of the shoemaker? The name of the shoemaker was Mr. Gessler, who lived with his elder brother in their shop in London. And the name of their shop was the Gessler Brothers. He used to make boots only on orders. Once the author questioned Mr. Gessler if it was not awful to make those shoes perfectly fitting into the feet they were meant for. The man answered with a heavy German accent that it is an art. Now, the author tells that the Gessler brothers make boots only on orders. And once he asked him a question that what if the shoes doesn't perfectly fit the feet they were meant for, then the man answered that it is an art. Mr. Gessler will be engrossed in his boot making art most of the time and won't talk much with his customers. So Mr. Gessler was very hardworking and he always keep himself busy in making boots. He strongly admired every piece of materials he used to work with. The boots made by Gessler brothers were of supreme quality and lasted very long. But in one occasion, the author had a different experience. He complained about it to Mr. Gessler. To this, the old man promised that he will repair the shoe and if couldn't, he will return the money to the author. Now, the author was very impressed with Mr. Gessler and his work of shoemaking. But one day, he had a different experience. He complained about his shoes to Mr. Gessler. In return, Mr. Gessler said that I will repair it and if they will not be repaired, then I will return the money to you. Near Gessler's grief and the hard times in his life. On one occasion, while placing an order for a shoe, the author was a bit absent-minded. He was wearing a pair of boots bought in an emergency from a large shop. Mr. Gessler looked carefully and pressed at a point where the left boot was not comfortable. With a sad face, he commented that it hurts the customers, but still the big firms don't have any self-respect. Now, one day when the author came to Mr. Gessler's shop, he was giving his measurement when Mr. Gessler noticed that his boots were not fit. And he said that it hurts the customer, but still big firms don't have any self-respect. They lure customers with their advertisements and not with their works. Because of this, Mr. Gessler was losing on business. The author has heard such things for the first time from Mr. Gessler. He felt bad and ordered many pairs of boots instantly. After several months, he went to their shop again, but this time he mistook Mr. Gessler for his elder brother. Now, on listening to Mr. Gessler, the author felt very bad and he purchased many pairs of boots. Then after several months, he went back to their shop again, but this time he mistook Mr. Gessler for his elder brother. After a while, he realized his mistake and learned that the elder brother had passed away. He again ordered many pair of shoes and soon after that, he left for abroad. After returning back, he went to his favorite boot shop again. Now, at that time, he realized that the elder Gessler brother had passed away, and he was feeling so bad that he again ordered many pair of shoes and soon after that, he left for abroad. After returning from abroad, he again went to his favorite boot shop. This time, Mr. Gessler looked more aged. Only a year had passed, but from his face, it appeared as though he has covered a journey of a decade. Decade means a group of 10 years. The artists end, but with a bitter truth. Mr. Gessler failed to recognize the author. The author, as usual, placed his orders and this time the boots were better than ever. Now, when the author returned from abroad and he went again to his favorite boot shop, he noticed that Mr. Gessler had grew old. But Mr. Gessler was not able to recognize him. The author, as usual, placed his orders and he noticed that this time the quality of boots were very good. They were better than ever. The author one evening went personally to thank Mr. Gessler for such a splendid work. But the nameplate was missing from the shop. He found an English man inside. The man informed him that Mr. Gessler had passed away and they have taken up the shop. The man further added that Mr. Gessler died of starvation. Now, when the author returned to the shop personally to meet Mr. Gessler personally, he noticed that there was no nameplate on the shop. He found an English man inside and that man told the author that Mr. Gessler had passed away and they have taken up the shop. The man further told that Mr. Gessler died due to hunger. The man used to make all the boots himself. He never allowed anyone else to touch them. Used the finest quality leather and worked hard day and night to complete the orders in time. He made the best boots in London with the finest leather, yet he lost it to competition. As we know that in today's life, there is a lot of competition in the market. We as a customer are always attracted towards the hoardings or advertisements, not to the quality of the product. The same happened with Mr. Gessler. He was very good at his art and he was very hardworking. He always used fine quality of leather and worked hard day and night to complete the orders in time. But At last he lost it to competition. Everything that he earned went on paying rent for the shop and on buying leathers. He skipped his meals working for hours for each pair of boots. So, the moral of the story is to become a master at any skill. It takes the total effort of your heart, mind, and soul working together in unison. Now, your homework is you have to learn lesson 5. Now we shall discuss homework solution of lesson number 5, quality, lecture number 2. Now we shall discuss book exercise of lesson number 5, quality. The first exercise is given on page number 78 of your book under the heading Working with Language. The first question is, study the following phrases and their meanings. Use them appropriately to complete the sentences that follow. Like, look after, its meaning is take care of. Look down on, its meaning is disapprove or regard as inferior. Look in on someone, make a short visit. Look into means investigate. Look out means be careful. Look up means improve. Look up to means admire. Now we have to use those phrases in these fill-ups. The first is, after a very long spell of heat, the weather is dash at last. Second, we have no right to dash people who do small jobs. Third, Nitin has always dash his uncle who is a self-made man. Fourth, the police are dash the matter thoroughly. Fifth, if you want to go out, I will dash the children for you. Sixth, I promise to dash on your brother when I visit Lucknow next. And seventh, dash when you are crossing the main road. Now look at the answers. First, after a very long spell of heat, the weather is looking up at last. First, looking up. Second, we have no right to look down on people who do small jobs. The answer is look down on. Third, Nitin has always looked up to his uncle who is a self-made man. Looked up to. Fourth, the police are looking into the matter thoroughly. The answer is looking into. Fifth, if you want to go out, I will look after the children for you. The answer is look after. Sixth, I promise to look in on your brother when I visit Lucknow next. The answer is look in. Seventh, look out when you are crossing the main road. The answer is look out. Now the second exercise is given on page number 79 of your Honeycomb book. The second exercise is read the following sets of words loudly and clearly. Cot, coat. Coast, coast. Toast, toast. Got, goat. Rot, rot. Blot, bloat. Not, note. Now this question requires you to use your own perspective as well as your analytical skills. The answer to the question would vary from one person to another. It is suggested that you read the text carefully and try attempting it on your own. Means you have to read it on your own. The third question is given on page number 79. The question is, each of the following words contains the sound SH, or we can say sh, as in shine, in the beginning or in the middle or at the end. First speak out all the words clearly, then arrange the words in three groups in the table on page number 80. Now look at the words: sheep, anxious, portion, shoe, trash, shriek, ashes, pushing, marsh, shore, sure, polish, fashion, fish, nation, mustache. Now, these are the categories in which you have to divide all these words. Okay, initial, medial, and final. Now see the answers. In initial means the sound which is coming in starting. The words in which the sound of SH is coming in starting are sheep, shriek, shore, sure, and shoe. Medial means the category where the sound of SH or sh is coming in middle. Fashion, anxious, portion, ashes, nation, pushing. And final means SH sound is coming at end. Trash, marsh, fish, polish, mustache. Now the fourth question is, in each of the following words, CH represents the same consonant sound as in chair. The words on the left have this sound initially. Those on the right have it finally. Initially means in starting, finally means at last. Speak each word clearly. Now see the words: choose, child, cheese, chair, charming. In these words, the sound was coming initially. Now look at the words like bench, march, peach, wretch, research. In these words, the sound is coming at last. Now what you have to do, you have to underline the letters representing the sound in each of the following words: feature, archery, picture, reaching, nature, matches, riches, batch, church. Now see the answers: feature, TU in middle, archery in middle, picture, reaching, nature, matches, riches, batch, and church. Like this, you have to underline in your books. Okay? Thank you. This is all for your lesson number 5, quality. I hope you understood it. If you like the video, then please like the video and subscribe to the channel.